الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى والدين الحق ليظهر على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد الله رب العزة says in the Quran إنه من يأتي ربه مجرما فإن له جهنم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا. The one who comes to his Lord as a criminal will never die and he will live eternal. Today there's so many criminals around the world. They're declared to be criminals in this dunya. And their crime is what? Involvement with the devil to help them. And they excel in the crime and no one is holding them accountable. In the societies, they are stars. In the societies, they are entertainers. While in fact, Allah says they are criminal. كُلُوا وَتَمَتَّعُوا قَلِيلًا إِنَّكُمْ مُجْرِمُونَ. Eat and enjoy a little bit, but you are a criminal. Who are these criminals I'm talking about? I'm talking about of these mujrims, the ones who do things behind the scene, the one who ask the devil jinn to help them with an action which is more beloved to the devil. This action is to separate from husband and wife, from brother and sister, from mother and a daughter, mother and a son, mother and grandson, mother and a sister, cousins, all the kings and all the branch, the tree of the family, to separate them. This is more beloved to the devil jinn than any other actions. Why do I say that? I jump straight to the hadith of Nabiullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, every day the shaitan gathers all of them in front of the big shaitan in his chair in the water. And then everybody comes and say, me, I have never left until he commits zina. Another one says, I have never left until he drank alcohol. I have never left until he smoked weed. I have never left until he backbite so and so. I have never left until he done such action, such action. And one will jump and say, I have never left until I have separated husband and wife. And the shaitan, jinn, iblis, la'natullah, will say, you are the one, you are the one. And he will say, come to me. And then he'll give him his crown to that one. Why this action is more beloved to the shaitan jinn? One is the ummah start from a father and a mother. Second is, when there is no father or there is no mother, the kids, the children will struggle. There will be an emptiness inside them, an emptiness where it can only be filled by a dad and a mom. This emptiness will drag or will lead to a confusion and depression. And this emptiness, again, it will be a trend to the same children. They will have the same routine. Oh, my father and my dad separated. Who cares if they got married again? They're just going to go the same routine unless Allah decreed them otherwise. The ummah start from home. Now the children have no father. They are with their mother. The mother cannot cope with all the children. Mother has a soft touch to the children. Even the father has a soft touch, but the children, they more look to the guidance of the father. And if there's no father there, there will be a traumatic house. Children will be traumatized there. This is why he's more beloved to the Iblis, because he'll be their father. He'll be the guidance there. This is what Allah says, يُفَرِّقُونَ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَالزَّوْجِ. They separate from husband and wife. This action, Allah mentioned it in the Quran because there's a purpose in it. There's a wisdom behind it. The house can only be built upon one foundation, a father and a mother. When there's no father and the mother, it's not a house anymore. It will be a ruined home, even though all the children will be happy having gadget, having this, having that, having that. But this is the worst. When you go abroad, when you find a house which has been ruined through black magic of separation, it's very difficult when you look at the state of these children. I have witnessed myself. The mother and the father are separated because of black magic, because a mujrim, a criminal person out there who sees these couples are enjoying and they are raising their children and say, no, I need to do something and destroy the enjoyment they are enjoying, the happiness, the contentment. I need to remove that. And he goes and does it and seek the help of the devil and does something, boom, and then done. Majority of this sihr tafriq, black magic of separation, hits the sisters and they can't cope. 90% I have seen it hits the sisters. Although it hits the brothers as well, because the brothers are not immune from magic. Everyone is not immune from calamity. And then what happens? What is next? You will see a ruined house. If you can go inside the brain of these children who their house is ruined, or their heart, you will fall into tears. It's only them who knows what is missing from their heart. And it's only the mother knows what is missing from her heart and from her brain. It's only the father knows what is missing from the heart and his conscious mind. Because it's not him willingly wanted to depart, but he was forced behind the scene. That's why I say, Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَأْتِي رَبُّهُ مُجْرِمًا فَإِنَّ لَهُ جَهَنَّمَ لَا يَمُوتُ فِيهَا وَلَا يَحْيَى. The one who comes to his Lord as a criminal, he will dwell in the hellfire forever. He will never die. He will live forever. Sihr al-Tafriq, black magic of separation, it's very common. Pakistanis, Somalis, Yemenis, Egyptians, Mauritanians, Libyan, Algeria, you mention it, Sudan, it's there. I have read on all these communities and I have seen it. Moroccans separated because of black magic. Somalis separated. Pakistanis separated because of black magic of separation. Bengalis, same. So it's not only in one community. It is widespread. We need to take heed and we need to protect our families. We need to look vividly who's the enemy and put a barrier to it. This is the message. And if you are hit by black magic of separation, be patient and seek help from Allah Rabbul Izzah. Because Allah Rabbul Izzah says in the Quran, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَسْبِرْ. The one who fears and be patient, you will achieve greatness. Don't rush to separation. Try and look way out and destroy the sihr. Allah has given us a book where he says, فيه شفاع. There is a شفاع in the book of Allah, Quran. هذا كتاب أنزلناه مبارك. This is a blessed book. Read the book of Allah. Ask Allah to show you where is the sihr. Sihr al-tafriq is one of the wickedest magic. Is from the sihr al-haqiqi, the true magic. Don't rush to separate. Ask Allah to help you. And Allah is not asleep. Allah is fully aware of what they are doing. Allah will aid you, but he wants you to be patient. Sihr al-tafriq is one of the wickedest magic. Wicked, I repeat, because it does not only involve two individuals. It involves a lot. Sometimes only two individuals, but when it's hit in a marriage, it destroys 4 to 5 to 6 to 7 individuals. There is signs on it. My main focus is between the husband and wife. The envious person takes the belongings of either the husband or the wife, either the hair from the armpit, the hair from the private part, the hair from the head, or the hair from the beard, and they represent it to the magician, mal'un kafir, or they take a picture, or cloth. Now, if they can't find all these, they sprinkle in your property. They bury in your property, and then you get hit by the will of Allah. If you have these signs, know that you've been hit by black magic of separation. From love to hate, instantly. You wonder what happened. These two people were very loving and caring about each other. And suddenly, hate to the extreme. The individual will hate to sit near that person. The individual will hate to hear any word from that person or any idea. He will find it disgusting. Any small argument will lead to a massive argument. The individual will be doubting each other. The wife, when she looks at the husband, she sees a different figure, an ugly figure. The husband, likewise, ugly figure. When they are far away from each other, they love. They communicate over the phone. When they are together, they fight very badly. You will be surprised what is happening to them. There is no solution. Their families join in to help for solution, but no solution. The jinns who come there to strengthen that magic makes the individual hallucinate. When they look at the husband, they see different figure. When they look at the wife, they see different figure. Hate to sit next to each other. Hate wherever the individual is. They hate it. They don't want to get near to it. Dreaming a lot of an ugly man. Dreaming a lot of an ugly woman. Fighting every day. The house is on fire every day. When the husbands leave the house or the wife leave the house, one of the companions feel relief. Either the husband will feel relief or the wife will feel relief. Like a burden been removed from there. Having thoughts of suicidal and thinking, why am I with him? Or why am I with her? She's not worthy me, or he's not worthy me. Not worthy living together. I need to find a way out. And these thoughts, the individual thinks is him, but is the shaitan bombarding him. Insomnia, lack of sleep, because of the black magic of separation, if it's strong there. We ask Allah to make it easy for the believing men and women and their children. How to move forward? It's very simple. Return back towards Allah and strive. Make dua sincerely. Seek isti'ana towards Allah and always be upon wudu. 2, get ruqya done and call somebody to investigate the full house. A professional raqi. A raqi who's been there for years doing ruqya. And read Surah Al-Baqarah daily. Twice, 3 times a day. And have hijama. And sit together as a family, husband and wife. Cooperate. Question yourselves, why is this happening? Sit together, read together Surah Al-Baqarah. If you don't know how to read, play the Quran and repeat while it's been read. It's going to take minimum of 1 hour to 2 hours. Now, if you've eaten or drunk, find a way how to remove it. If not, if it was sprinkled outside, inshallah, read Surah Al-Baqarah, sprinkle your whole house regularly in and out. If it's been buried, ask Allah to show you. And Allah Rabbul Izzah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تنتقوا الله يجعل لكم فرقانا. If you fear Allah, Allah will show you the truth. So stay together, read Quran together, work together. Black magic of separation, let me tell you something. The only way forward is to work together and destroy it. Because once you separate, it will carry on. You will go to get married again, problem. She will go and get married again, problem. It will become sihrul mustamir. Watch out for this one, inshallah. In the future, I will talk about sihrul mustamir. It will continue wherever you go and ask Allah for help. Like I said, if it's in the stomach, try and vomit and remove it. If it's in the house, try and sprinkle all your house. Do not rush for separation. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم